Welcome to the session. So last class we discussed about how we are implementing a stack using linked list, and two applications also covered. One is reverse of a list and another one is how we are finding the recursion, factorial of a given number by using recursion and as well as with the help of stack. So in the today's session, we are going to discuss about two more applications. So one is how to convert infix expression into postfix, and another one is how to evaluate a postfix notation. So first of all, I am giving a brief introduction about what is an arithmetic expression and how a system is evaluate this kind of expressions. Okay, so the first thing is evaluation of arithmetic expressions. So arithmetic expressions are nothing but an expression consists of arithmetic operators. Say for example, the given expression may like this, say A plus B. So here the plus is called as binary operator. A and B are called as operands. A and B are called as operands. Plus is a binary operator. So it performs arithmetic addition in between A and B. Okay, it performs an operation in between A and B, and it gives the result. So what kind of expression it is? It is an infix expression. According to our terminology, infix expression. Operator is surrounded with operands is called as infix expression. Okay. Suppose the same expression we are written as like this, plus AB means the first operator followed by operands. This kind of expression is called as prefix expression. This kind of expressions are called as prefix expression. Say for example, we are written like this, AB plus. This kind of expression is called as postfix expression. So expressions are mainly expressing in three different ways. One is infix expression, another one is prefix expression, third one is postfix expression. Okay, the same thing here I have also mentioned, infix, postfix and prefix. So the notations are three different but equivalent to the notation of right algebraic expressions. Algebraic expressions means like this. So whenever we want to evaluate, an expressions, at the time we have to know two different things. One is precedence and another one is associativity of operators. So first I am giving a brief introduction about what are the arithmetic operators: plus, minus, multiplication, division, modulo. Here these two are having low priority comparatively these three. So these three are high priority. And according to precedence, left to right, which one comes first, that one is executed. Here also left to right is a associativity. Also we have to evaluate this kind of expression right now. Means I am calculating equivalent postfix expression for the given infix expression. So how to find out postfix expression for the given infix expression we want to find right now? Okay, so first see, here we are following Bodmer's rule. Or while I am solving this problem, I am explaining one by one constraint. Okay, so the given expression consists of sub expressions. At the time, first sub expressions evaluates first, followed by precedence and associativity.
So here, this is a one sub-expression, this is a another sub-expression. In this case, we are following left to right associativity. Right. So for that, so first I am evaluating this expression. So A minus B, it's an infix expression. What is the equivalence postfix expression for this is AB minus. AB minus. Okay. So AB minus into, so this is the one expression. After that, C plus D. So later we are evaluating that one also. So AB minus 1. C, D plus. See here, for differentiating purpose, I am written parenthesis. Once we are evaluated sub expression, parenthesis are not copied as the same one. Parenthesis are not copied as the same one. Okay. So we are evaluating like this. After that, say this is a x, this is a y. So the present expression is x into y. So what is the equivalent post this expression is? Okay. XY multiplication. So after that I am substituting the values. So AB minus CD plus multiplication. Like this I am doing. Okay. So this is the way of calculating postfix expression for the given infix expression. This is a very 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 important concept. Damn sure concept in stats. Similarly here also, so this is a one sub-expression, this is another sub-expression, this is another sub-expression. Here also we have to do the same thing. First this one is evaluated, AB plus. After that this one is evaluated, so CD plus. After that this one is evaluated, DE star. DE star. So assume this one is a x, this one is a y, this one is a z. So what is the current expression is x divided by y minus z. Up to now we are following only one rule. First I will use the sub expression first from left to right. Okay, so here two operators are there, one is division, another one is subtraction. One is division, another one is subtraction. So both are having equal precedence? No. Division goes to highest precedence than subtraction. So the first division is evaluated. Means this one is evaluated. So x, y divided by. Okay. After that followed by this one. So what is the resultant one finally? X, y divided by z minus. So here we have to substitute the value of x. So a, b plus y value, c, d plus divided by z value, d, e star minus. This is the traditional process we are following to convert infix expression into postfix expression. Okay. How we have written the logic, and before of this, first, I am going to discuss about why we want to convert each and every expression into postfix form. Each and every expression into postfix form. Why? Because being a human, we know that comparatively division and minus, okay, division goes to highest precedence, so this one is evaluated first. How the computer identifies by comparatively these two operators, which operator precedence is high? It's highly impossible. Highly impossible. That's why the computer first converts the infix expression into postfix. Based on the postfix expression, it evaluates the expression. Based on the postfix expression, we are evaluating the given infix or algebraic expression. That is the process. That's why we have to know how to convert infix into postfix. So this is the same thing. So in the postfix notation, as the name suggests, the operator is placed after the operands. Means here, postfix expression, this is an operator, this is a operands. So the order of evaluation of postfix expression always from left to right. Left to right. So this is the way to find out postfix expression from the given infix expression. Next thing. So this is the process we are following logically in the algorithm. First, I am explaining the algorithm. Later, I am going to discuss about how to do this process. How to do this process. So first, I already told that highest priority is multiplication, division, modulo, followed by least priority is plus and minus. So we want to evaluate this expression. So we know that this is an infix expression. How the system is generated postfix expression for this? What is the algorithm we are following right now? We have to discuss it. And the second point is how it is an application of stack. How this one is an application of stack. So here, clearly visible, this is a stack. This is a stack. So the first step is scan the given infix expression from left to right. Means we are starting from here, ending from here. We are following like this. Left to right. Algorithm is very easy. Just concentrate it. So scan the given infix expression from left to right. Second point is, while scanning each and every character, say the first character may be A. A is an operand. So if it is an operand, directly store into the postfix array. If it is an operand, directly store into the postfix array. If it is an operator, push into the stack. The first division is, if it is an operand, store in the postfix array. If it is an operator, push into the stack. Next, while pushing to the stack, we have to check the operator, means stack topper operator precedence, should be less than this operator. Then only you can directly push the operator on this operator. Suppose this operator precedence, stack top operator precedence is high, then our currently operator automatically pop this operator, means delete the operator and store in the postfix array, and later doing the same thing. Again, one more stack top operator maybe is there. Again, you have to check these two operator precedences again. Until we get this operator precedence is lesser than this operator precedence, then only you can push on this. That is the condition. Okay. For suppose, here some exclusions are there. Suppose we are getting open parenthesis. Suppose stack top operator consists of open parenthesis. Directly push whatever will be the operator you have directly on this. No need to check precedence. Only the stack top one is a operator. Then only you have to check precedence. The stack top consists of open parenthesis. No need to check any precedence. Starting. So first I am starting my work. So first by default I am pushing one open parenthesis to find out the stack is empty or not. So for that case, initially I am inserting one open parenthesis into the stack. So the first scanned character is A. A is an operand directly stored in the postfix array, postfix expression. So the stack status is only open parenthesis only. The next scanned character minus. So minus is an operator. So push into the stack. Push into the stack. So here open parenthesis, no need to check precedence. No need to check precedence. Next, again open parenthesis. Push into the stack. Next scan character B. B is an operand. B is an operand. So if it is an operand, directly stored into the postfix. So stack status doesn't change. Next, division operator. So stack top consists of parentheses, directly push into the stack, no need to check precedences and all. So the next one is C. C is an operand, directly stored into the postfix array. Directly stored into the postfix array. So the next is current character plus. So what is the stack top operator? Division. What is the stack top operator? Division. So comparatively, division plus C is the highest precedence? No. Least preference. That's why pop and store into the postfix array. Then next, what you are getting? So this is deleted. The next you are getting open parenthesis. Once you are getting open parenthesis, push into the stack. So that's why I am pushing plus. I am repeating once again. Comparatively, division plus is the least priority. So we cannot make it as division followed by plus. That is wrong. Stack top lo already division undi. Okay. So here currently inserted operator is plus. Comparatively division plus is to least priority. So that's why I am popping this, then I am pushing the plus into stack. Okay. So the next one is open parenthesis. Open parenthesis directly pushed into the stack. Next D. D is an operand. Operand. So directly stored in a postfix array. No need to change. Next, modulo operator. So stack top consists of open parenthesis. So directly push into the stack. Directly push into the stack. Next, E. E is an operand. So directly stored in a postfix array. Directly stored in a postfix array. Next, multiplication. Multiplication is an operator. Okay. So what is the stack top? Modulo. Modulo and multiplication both are having equal priority. So if it is an equal priority, directly push into the stack. Directly push into the stack. So no need to change. Next, F is an operand, directly stored in a postfix array. Next, closing parenthesis. This is a very, very important condition. Till now we are not getting this kind of case. When we are getting closed parenthesis, until we want to pop getting open parenthesis. When we are getting closed parenthesis, up to we want to get open parenthesis, all the operators pop and store in a postfix array. So here we are getting closed parenthesis. What is the stack top operator? Multiplication. Stored into postfix array. Modulo. Stored into the postfix array. Open parenthesis. So, like until open parenthesis, we want to delete and all. And here we are not saving any open parenthesis into stack. Open parenthesis, closed parenthesis are not saved in the stack. Okay, stack means nothing but postfix array also. Right. Next, we are getting division. So, what is the stack top? Plus. Plus is the least priority, division gets the highest priority, directly push into the stack. No problem. Next, G. G is an operand, directly stored into the postfix array. Next, closed parenthesis. When we are getting closed parenthesis, until we want to get open parenthesis, pop all the character, operators from the stack. So here two operators. So division is pop, plus is pop, closed parenthesis also pop. So this is the status. This is the status. And next, we are getting multiplication. So what is the stack top? Minus. Comparatively minus, multiplication goes to highest priority. So directly push into the stack. So we are pushing to the stack. Next, H. H is an operand. So directly stored in a postfix array. Next, closed parenthesis. When we are getting closed parenthesis, until we will get open parenthesis, pop all the characters. So pop all the characters. So multiplication, division. So here only one change is, here closing parenthesis is not there, here open parenthesis also not there. We are assuming that the first one is a open parenthesis, last one is a closed parenthesis. So stack is empty right now. So stack is empty here. Okay. So this is the way to convert infix expression into postfix expression. Infix expression into postfix. The first one. scan the characters from left to right, each and every time one character. If it is an operand, directly stored into a postfix array. If it is an operator, we need to check the precedence with the stacktop operator. So the stacktop consists of open branches, no need to check any precedence. Okay, no need to check any precedence. And last one is, if you are getting closed branches, until we will get open branches, we want to pop all the operators and we need to store in a postfix array. Okay, interesting application on this is sometimes parenthesis checker. Parenthesis checker means that suppose here I am given three open branches, three closed branches we are getting or not. Suppose we are not getting three closed branches, it is an invalid expression. Directly you can say invalid expression. Parentheses are not balanced. Parentheses should be balanced. So this is open branches, closed branches. Open branches, closed branches. Balance. So sometimes we can use the same application for parenthesis checker also. Parenthesis checker also. Right. So how to write a code for this? How to write a code for this? Okay. So first. So void infix to postfix. Okay. The same function we need to copy in the stack IDT. Stack IDT, at the time the stack IDT should be character. Okay. So first, char of infix expression I am passing as an argument. Char of postfix expression, this one is also passed as an argument. Infix expression, postfix expression. So this is our input, this is our output. We are passing both the strings. We are passing both the strings. When we are passing the character array as an argument, no need to pass the size of an array. Why? Because string ends with null character. String ends with null character. So the first, say int I. I is used for loop counter variable. So first, for I is equal to 0. I is equal to 0. And here, I am putting a condition, infix of i not equal to null character. We want to iterate this loop. And later i plus plus. Each and every time we are incrementing the index one time. So the first, what we have to do? First, we want to scan the first character. So if infix of i consists of the first character. According to our algorithm, the first infix of i is open parenthesis. If it is open parenthesis, push into the stack. Okay, so we need to check all the cases. So infix of i double equal to open parenthesis, push into the stack. So push into the stack. Push infix of i directly. Suppose else if, this is not the case. Else if infix of i may be closed parenthesis. So we need to pop each and every one and we want to store in a postfix array. Postfix array. So here the postfix array index is separate. Postfix array index is separate. Both are not same. So for storing the postfix array index, I am starting j is equal to 0. J is the postfix array index. Okay. So if infix of i is equal to closed parenthesis, directly I am writing PO of plus plus of j equal to pop. So the pop function pops one element from the stack and directly stored into the postfix array. See, here we want to check whether the pop element is a closed parenthesis or not. Pop element is a closed parenthesis or not. So we need to put some condition here. So what type of condition we are putting? Say, while listen carefully. Why? Peak. What is peak? Peak refers to top of the element. Okay. So peak double equal to open parenthesis. Until we will get open parenthesis, we want to pop na. So that's why peak is equal to open parenthesis R naught. Then only this statement is executed. Okay. So why? Then this statement means pop one character from the stack. So mean operator stored in a postfix array. Again while loop. Again it checks peak whether it is an open parenthesis or not. If it is not an open parenthesis, again pop and store into the postfix array. Until we will get open parenthesis, we are getting pop. When we are getting open parenthesis, see here we have to write not equal to only then we are storing the postfix array. When we are getting equal, comes out of from the while loop. So here else if is closed. Here we are covered only two cases: open parenthesis directly pushed into the stack, closed parenthesis until we will get open parenthesis, we need to pop one by one operator and store into the postfix array. Next, else if. What are the remaining cases? If it is an operator. So before going to operator, operand. So for checking it is an operand or not, so we have two different kinds of functions. One is alpha. Suppose you are passing digits, say 1, 2, 3 kind of thing. In that case also, the program should be works. Means we have to write is digit of infix of I. Is digit of infix of I. So is alpha function is in C type dot H. So is alpha function, if it is an operand, returns true. If it is not an operand, it returns false. So if it is an operand, what we have to do? Store in a postfix array. That's it. Whether it is an alpha bit is nothing but A, B, and so on, Z. Digit is nothing but 1, 2, and so on, 0. Both the cases directly store into the postfix array. So what is the last case? If it is an operator. So the last case is else. So if it is an operator, we have to check one by one. Infix of I double equal to plus. Logical R. Infix of I double equal to minus. Logical R. Infix of I double equal to multiplication. Like that, we need to add 5 different conditions. Logical R means if any one condition is true. So other than what we have to do? We need to check the precedence of operator. Stack top operator precedence and current operator precedence we have to check. So for precedence check, we have to write one more function. So in this case, we are entering into the inner one. And in the inner one, we need to check precedence. Precedence is a one function. It's a user-defined function. We have to write with your own knowledge. Okay. So precedence of what is the stack top? Stack, how to get stack top? Means peak. When we are invoking peak function, it returns the top of the operator. Stack top of the operator. Okay. So we need to check stack top operator precedence. Stack top operator precedence should be greater. And then automatically push into the stack. Okay. So we need to check. So less than. And we need to check the precedence of infix of I. We need to check precedence of infix of I. In that case, what we have to do? Pop. Means again, postfix of plus plus j is equal to What is the stack term? So pop. Pop operator. Copy it into the same. Again we have to check. So here we have to use while. Okay. In other case, suppose this is the not the case. What is the one more case we are getting here? One more case. So here we have to ask one more condition also. What is the condition is? Suppose if the peak returns open parenthesis, what do you have to do? Directly push into the stack. So push infix array. So this is the case, else is closed. So totally it is open parenthesis, second one closed parenthesis, third one operand, fourth one operator. Okay, so the next case, what are the different kinds of applications of this stack? So evaluation of postfix expression, just now we want to see, I already explained, whenever a computer, see, the easy of evolution acts as driving the force of computer to translate infix notation into postfix notation. The computer evolutes infix expression. How it evolutes the infix expression is first to convert the infix expression into postfix. Okay, next, the given algebraic expression written infix notation, the computer first converts the expression into equivalent postfix expression and then evolute the postfix expression. So using stacks, postfix expression be evaluated very easily. That is the first advantage here. And second advantage is, if the character uncount is an operand, it is pushed into the stack. So this is the, what is the steps we have followed in the previous algorithm, the same thing I have explained with you. Okay, so this is the next kind of application, how the postfix expression is evaluated in the system. Okay, since this is a first infix expression, the equivalent infix expression, this is an equivalent postfix expression. How infix expression is converted into postfix, we already seen right now. How this expression is evaluated, postfix expression is evaluated, we want to see right now. So the first, what is the step? Say it is an operand. So if it is an operand, push into the stack. Reverse process. In the previous, if it is an operand, store in a postfix array. It is an operator, just push into the stack. But right now, it is an operand, push into the stack. If it is an operator, perform the operation and find the result, store the result into stack. So operand push into the stack. So that's why 9 push into the stack. Next 3 is also operand push into the stack. Next 4 is also operand push into the stack. Next multiplication. So when we are getting multiplication, so pop the two operands, perform the operation and push the final result. So what is the status is, so 9, 3 into 4, 12, so 12 is pushed into the stack. So here also same thing, 3 push into the stack, 4 push into the stack, when we are getting multiplication, 9, 12. Next, we are getting 8. 8 is an operand, push into the stack. Next, plus, when we are getting operator, pop the top two operands, perform the operation, and result push into the stack. So 9, 20. So there also 9, 20. Next, 4. So 4 is an operand, push into the stack. Next, divided by. When we are getting divided by, again pop the two things, find out the result. Okay, so how we are getting a result? 20 divided by 4. This is operand 1, this is operand 2. So 20 divided by 4, so 5. So we are getting 9, 5. Next operand, 5. minus. So what is the resultant? 9 minus 5 means 4. So the 4 is pushed into the stack. So finally the result 4. So this is the way the postfix expression is evaluated. Very easy technique. Very simple logic is, whenever it is an operand pushed into the stack, whenever we are getting an operator, just pop the two operands, perform the operation, and the resultant one is pushed into the stack. At last, the result is in stack. So just try code for this. It's a very simplest code. Just try for the code. So then finally, I'm going to summary. So these are the three different kind of applications. I'm giving the problems as a worked examples for you. So at your home, practice it. See, infix to postfix expression is a very, very important concept. Damn sure question. So that's why, by using the algorithm, try to solve these three different kinds of examples. Okay, later, just write a code for postfix expression evaluation. Okay, later you can write postfix expression evaluation code. So in the today's class, I have explained two different kinds of applications. One is how to convert infix expression into postfix expression. That is the first thing I have explained. And the second thing is how the postfix expression is evaluated. Postfix expression evaluation is explained. So these two are the very, very important applications of this type.